To understand the support behavior coaches can provide teachers, we need to talk about the support Round Rock ISD teachers can provide their students. I understand that many of you are knowledgeable of our multi-tiered system of supports, or MTSS, for our students. It is important to review MTSS for this discussion. MTSS is more comprehensive than RTI. MTSS goes beyond academics and also covers social and emotional supports. Neuroscience research shows that emotion, attention, and learning are all linked. Social-emotional learning, or SEL, leads to a positive school climate. When social-emotional learning skills are explicitly taught to both students and staff and practiced, this can lead to a less stressful school environment, a stronger focus on learning, and positive relationship between students and staff. Because of this, social-emotional learning is part of each of the three tiers of support. Social-emotional learning helps students of every age develop their self-awareness. It teaches them how to properly respond to situations they face at school and in the outside world. With teaching social-emotional learning skills, we are addressing a potential skill gap that often gets overlooked. As educators, we are always focused on addressing academic skill gaps in, say, math and reading. But teaching social-emotional learning helps close up the skill gap that some students might have in regards to their own social and emotional awareness. Last year, when all Round Rock ISD students were virtual, the behavior instructional coaches helped put together the relational roadmaps, which provided educators on all different grade levels with weekly social-emotional learning lessons. If you find yourself in need of guidance on how to incorporate social-emotional learning lessons into your daily lesson planning, a behavior instructional coach can provide guidance. There are other ways that behavior instructional coaches can support teachers that are providing Tier 1 support to their students. Brand new teachers might feel the need for coaching on classroom management. Requesting coaching from a behavior instructional coach early on in the school year, before major disruptive behaviors begin to present themselves, is a proactive step. Going through the coaching process throughout the school year is a way to stay within Covey's second quadrant, working on important skills that might not seem urgent. Veteran teachers might feel they need a refresher on classroom management too. Another way that teachers provide Tier 1 support for their students is by hanging visible signs within the classroom to remind students of classroom expectations. These school-wide expectations are part of the campus-wide behavior intervention and support system, or PBIS. Some examples of PBIS are capturing kids' hearts, emergentry, and restorative practices. The Gen Ed behavior instructional coaches have received training in restorative practices. I often recommend Tier 1 restorative practice strategies when I'm putting together teacher coaching documents or writing up observation reports on specific students. Some Tier 1 restorative practice strategies include incorporating a pulse meter in your classroom or building in 60-second relay breaks and 90-second spark plans into your daily lesson planning. In general, using these strategies will lead to a deeper understanding of each of your students, but will also provide positive attention to students that might demonstrate attention-seeking behavior. You are proactively providing positive attention to students instead of providing attention to them by reacting to their behaviors. While setting up the Tier 1 support they will provide, the classroom teacher is establishing simple and defined expectations for their students. They have specific plans for classroom procedures mapped out, and throughout the course of the school year, the students are practicing these procedures, and the teachers are reviewing the procedures whenever needed. Reviewing classroom procedures is another example of Covey's Quadrant 2 type work. It might not seem urgent or needed to review classroom procedures and expectations for each activity, but it is important. A student is only able to demonstrate on-task behavior if they know what on-task behavior looks like. If a teacher is requesting coaching, myself or one of the four other behavior instructional coaches will observe their classes. We can observe your classroom management put into action and provide feedback on what we think is working, what we think is not working, and offer up suggestions on other strategies to incorporate. If you believe that you could benefit from coaching, speak to your administrator and they can fill out our simple teacher coaching request form.